and to welcome you all today to the graduation of the class of 2022. The students sitting here before you this afternoon have persevered in more ways than one, and it is a great joy that we are able to celebrate this afternoon with all of you. The class of 2022 represents so much. These students are athletes and musicians and artists. They are writers, engineers, and problem solvers. They're workers, volunteers, missionaries, and leaders. They are strugglers, fighters, and survivors. They are hardworking, creative, and kind. They are your children, your grandchildren, your neighbors, your sisters and brothers, and your friends. Here at Chapelgate, we believe that all that we do and all that we are is for God's glory. As Matthew 14 states, be the light of the world. Each of you are created uniquely in God's image, and we are thankful for you and the marks that you have each left here at the Academy. I encourage you all to go and be the light of the world. And now I introduce to you Hannah Daly.
Dear God, we come to thank you for gathering us all here together on such an important day. Thank you, God, for your unwavering love, your kindness, and for guiding us at every step of our journey. Your never-ending support and mercy has given us graduates the abilities required for this accomplishment. Thank you for providing the teachers, staff, coaches, counselors, and mentors who have taught us and took care of us along the way. Thank you for giving us the family and friends who are here, who have helped us build us into the individuals we are today. God, as this door closes and another one opens, please give us strength and wisdom as we face these unknown challenges. Help us use the knowledge, skills, and insights that we have gained as we go out into the world. Continue to bless us, surround us with your protection, love, mercy, grace, Father. May we all live to honor and grow by your name. In your name we pray. Amen. Amen. Much
parents and family made the decision to put us in this environment, in this school. And it's a place where we have good relationships and we can care for one another. That was a sacrifice, and at times a financial sacrifice, we felt was worth it to put us in at great expense. But it's out of love for the betterment of your student. So thank you for putting us here and the opportunity to be here now. And we get to be in the school where the Bible is proclaimed as absolute truth. That's the foundation of the rest of the academics. And that can be done without the teachers, of course. So we as a class thank you, teachers. These teachers, we thank you for preparing the lessons and teaching the classes and grading the work. And I think genuinely get everything about us. From Mr. Dingle's Bible class to Mr. Apple's English class, just a few that a lot of us have been in this year. We have a classroom structure, open discussion, honest conversation, comical times, and that makes an environment where we can be comfortable with one another. That environment is very strong academics, though. Academics are sacrificing the cost of having a relationship with the teacher. The quality and the level of learning, I think, is enhanced by that. And so again, thank you, teacher. Now, this Christian education that we have within West Ave, that will equip us to go on into the future, from here into the world, the next steps in life. And as we leave here, we're graduating, it's a result of a lot of years of work, and I mean, it seems kind of trite to say that. Everyone says we did it, but it was many years of work. And as typical as it may sound, it's worth saying that it took a lot of work to get here today. And a lot of time and energy went into it. But we're not going to applaud ourselves yet because it wouldn't be very meaningful. Maybe not very encouraging to the family, the teachers, and even us students alike. For someone to come up and hear and say, "You did it. Good job." So many great things ahead. And all those things are true, but we're crossing a threshold, and that threshold is from high school to college. And we look forward to this next because it's not just more school, but it's not just more school. It's a whole year to offer an opportunity to help define what we're going to be doing in our lives vocationally, but also who we're going to be. And you can take advantage of those opportunities that await your learning. Saying who we are as people, not just what we do as a job. And we're going to take this next step harder with excitement. Thanks to God first, but with a lot of excitement for what we get to do. Thanks to our family and our school for bringing us here. With the firm foundation set by my family, all our families, and the school, and the truth. Our family, teachers, staff, coaches, they all pray that we be stronger and can grow in grace and knowledge. And they pray that we rely on God for guidance and direction and everything. From the toughest times and the mundane times and every day, and in the worst times, they pray that we rely on our things. And they pray that we live to be praying unceasingly. We pray all the time, that's a conversation. And to love reading the Word. And they pray these things because they really love us. I do that. Maybe, I'm speaking to my fellow classmates, maybe you're excited about how much academics can experience, the qualities, the abilities to make your own schedule, the because you'll have to change. And just get out of here and get out of the house. So, depending on what you consider to be free, obviously, like your folks last night might not be free at all. Whatever your top reason is for wanting to move on to college, all these new experiences, maybe the thing that scares you the least about college, but I don't know what I said. It's time for pursuing things that you like and to prepare for your life and your career. And I say this to myself as well, don't waste the time. I'm not here to tell you what to do by any means. I say these things by looking at myself and saying, don't waste the time. It's important to remind ourselves that being disciplined and productive is great, yeah. And doing so is very rewarding, but you also have to spend time doing things that you enjoy. And that's also very expensive. Graduating and going to college is a new milestone, and it's one in which you can start something new. You can change anything about how you work and manage your time, reward your priorities, but it's a transition that you can take advantage of. And I'm going to try to with my time management. Most importantly, to wrap it up, I'd say most importantly, wherever you are spiritually, I really encourage you to just run to him and find refuge in peace and joy. He understands you and your thoughts and feelings better than anyone else can, even your parents or someone who's really, really close to you. And I'd like to leave you with these two verses, the Proverbs 3:5. Trust in the Lord with all your heart, you do not live on your own understanding. And Romans 15:13, may the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace and communion, so that by the power of the Holy Spirit you may abound with him.
Achieved some pretty remarkable milestones for Chapelgate. This group sitting before you cumulatively was awarded more than $4 million in scholarship money for college. Jackson. Ben Johnson. Jumo Ibra Kang. Connor Mulligan. Yuna Oh, who is not with us tonight. And last but not least, Eric Spies. And it's my privilege to introduce to you our athletic director and keynote speaker, Mr. Ken Kravitz.
Good afternoon, parents, grandparents, family, friends, teachers, administration, and school board. Also, good afternoon, class of 2022. My name is Ken Kravitz. I'm the athletic director and activities director here at Chapelgate, and I am so honored and excited to speak to you today. Congratulations, class of 2022. What a wild 4 years it has been. Freshman year was a year of an adjustment, getting to know the ropes and settling into the start of your high school experience with wide eyes and a bit of uncertainty. Sophomore year, you were more familiar, ready, and confident. That's something that no one could ever predict to happen, and your lives would change forever. Worry, doubt, fear, and isolation became the normal. Classes on the screen from your house away from your friends was a daily routine. But that didn't stop you. You came back from your junior year and things were different. You were split up, learning on different days. Some students were in the building and others were not. The ones that were in the building were wearing masks, hiding smiling faces, and making it difficult to communicate at times. Again, you had to adjust to a new routine, but that didn't stop you. That brings us to this year, where you were asked to adjust one more time. Classrooms were full, the lunchroom was back to normal. Maybe it's Mr. Jordan, Mr. Fryerson. Retreats and field trips were added to the schedule, and you were asked to take exams again. The courts and fields were active with competition and teamwork, but they were still worried and concerned that it would all change again. But did you crack under the pressure of change? No, it didn't stop you, and you completed the task that you were given, stronger than you were before, with a renewed sense of hope for your future, and I applaud you for that, and you should applaud yourself for that. The Bible speaks of this in one of my favorite verses. It's something that I said to the Springs athletes last year, and it's actually on my board. It's Romans 5, 3-5. Not only so, but we also glory in our sufferings, because we know that suffering produces perseverance, perseverance character, and character hope. And hope does not put us to shame, because God's love has been poured into our hearts through the Holy Spirit, who has been given to us. Now you leave here hopeful about your future as young women and men. You always have persevered through a challenge that no one in this room has done at your age. Now the question is, where are you going? And I'm sure you've heard that quite a bit over the past year from friends, family, and teachers. I'll read you these verses. Where are you going? Where do you go? Are you looking for answers to questions under the stars? Lift along the way, you are grown weary. You can rest with me until a brighter day, and you're okay. If you are currently pulling out your phone and checking your Bible app, figure out where this is located. Number one, this is my little friend, and yell at you. But number two, you find it at First Day Matthews Band, album 5, song 3, which you need to switch over to Apple Music or Spotify to find that. They were one of the bands that got me through college. Going to school in Virginia in the mid-90s, you didn't have to walk far without hearing one of their songs coming out of the dorm room. Then I mentioned the school was ran off of Macon College, the 2022 Division III men's basketball national champion. That's what I did to prepare for this. I went back to when I was going to college and tried to figure out what I could tell you that I wish I would have known and that someday you would remember. Going back to that song, I don't know what the original meaning was when he wrote it, but that's the great thing about music. Once it's out in the universe, you kind of make it your own, and you can kind of put your own memories and your own feelings to it. But I think it fits in well to what I want to share with you. You're all even here today, and all of you are going out and looking for answers to questions under the stars. Nowadays, for some reason, you're expected to have your life planned as soon as you walk out of those doors. You're expected to have your major nailed down, know what internships you need in that field, have the exact job in mind, and even know what company you want to work for. Now, some of you know exactly what you want to do, and that is great. But there might be others sitting here that don't. Or maybe they pick something that they're unsure because they feel they just had to pick something. And I'm here to tell you that that is okay. God has a plan for each and every one of you, whether you know what you want or not. Here's what you all have in common. None of you know the plan fully. You might think you do, and you might be totally confident in it, but know that what he wants for you might not match up to what you think you want, or even the path to get to what you want. And I'm reminded of Isaiah 55:8, for my thoughts are not your thoughts, neither are your ways my ways, declares the Lord. And I look at myself standing here as that example. I started college as a psychology major. I wanted to help people with their problems. There were people in my life that I cared deeply about that were struggling, and I wanted to be that person to help them. Unfortunately, after 1 year of lackluster psych classes, I decided to change my major to something similar. This is economics. Put me further away from it, my tribe. At that time, I felt like I failed. I felt embarrassed, and I felt that I let people down. It meant a lot to me. Now, with the time and wisdom that God has given me, of his power and the way that he works, I realized that it was not a failure. It was God guiding me on the path that he went in, which was totally different than mine. Now, am I telling you to pack it in, put it on cruise control, and as they say, let Jesus take the wheel? Not totally. God asks for two things of us. One, to be an active participant while we are here, as it states in Proverbs 13:4. The soul of the sluggard prays and gets nothing, while the soul of the diligent is rich with supply. And for us to use the talents that he gave us to glorify him. It states in 1 Peter 4:10, each of you should use whatever gift you have received to serve others as faithful stewards of God's grace in its various forms. You were called as sons and daughters of Christ to give everything you have while you're on this earthly home. That is, Coach Steve is God's soldier. To give it the old college try. But even giving it everything you have doesn't guarantee anything. It doesn't mean that everything will go your way all the time. And again, that's okay. As I spoke at chapel a few months back, I thought God had me where he wanted me. I thought that I was where I was supposed to be for 20 plus years after I came out of college. I was interested in this, so I looked back on my phone to see where I was on this day, 2 years before I started working here at Chapelgate. 5 years ago, I was in a full Tyvek suit spraying 90 large metal panels in my shop, Royal Blue, for a job for my family business. If you're unfamiliar with what a Tyvek suit is, it's a white suit that has like hoodies and a zipper and a hood, so I can, when I can paint myself, I'm not ruining everything I'm wearing. 4 years ago, I was in downtown D.C. meeting 15 subcontractors to review a site plan for a future restaurant for the contractor that I was working for. A year later, I was in my house trying to figure out how to bring sports back to a school that I fell in love with. 3 different years, 3 different locations, and 3 different jobs. Each one served the purpose that God had to get me to be right here, right now, standing in front of you. If you were to ask me at any time in my life if I would be standing here giving this speech, I would have thought you'd be great. Because that would just be too unbelievable. But God is unbelievable. And I pray that you look for the unbelievable in your life. Even during the times that the unbelievable just doesn't seem to fit, you get a bad grade on a paper that you worked really hard on. You're not getting the minutes that you want in your college school. You didn't get the role that you wanted in the play that the drama department was put on. You struggle to fit in at the school and are forced with a decision that you need to make a change. Or your boss lets you go because you didn't fit what he was looking for the company. Trusting God, these are not roadblocks. They are detours. Rest in God that He is guiding you. Rainwater that falls on a mountain takes many paths before it gets to the ocean. It runs into many rocks, hits many fallen trees, but it never stops until it gets there. Just like you all navigated through your high school career, you never stop despite the rocks and the fallen trees. And I pray that you never do. The world is tough, trying, and scary at times. It feels more divided than any other time I can remember, and you're all probably becoming more aware of it now. You will feel stronger, you will hurt at times, and you will question as you search for answers under the stars, whether that is in the school or in the workforce. Just know that you can always rest with God when you grow weary until that brighter day and you're okay. He is always with you, and you can always strengthen Him. He is constantly working in your life, whether you realize it or not. And I wish I realized that earlier in mine. It would make the tough times a lot easier to manage. I feel confident that this group will accomplish tremendous things on this earth, being the hands and feet of Christ. Why? Because you have seen adversity. You have persevered. Your character has been shaped, and especially because you never stopped. You were guided to be right here and right now for a reason. Live every day like that. You were meant for this time, and I feel it's best said at the end of Esther 4:14, perhaps you were born for such a time as this. Thank you all for your time in the class of 2022. God's peace be with you on your journey for God's peace.
Ladies and gentlemen, we do a special thing here at Chapelgate at this time of graduation. We're so proud of each and every one of our students. I just can't tell you. We like to read a little word of praise that teachers have put together for these students. So we're going to ask that you would listen to that word before you applaud. And let's keep our focus on the graduates and not on the audience members. Thank you.
Jessica Buffalo Adager.
Yes, Jessica is one of the OGs of Chapelgate. A student here since the sixth grade, Jessica is a cheerleader in more ways than one. As an assistant in the lower school, Jessica cheers on and encourages our youngest students. And her bright smile lights up the basketball court during halftime shows. Jessica is headed off to the Citadel. We hope she packs her pom-poms because we can think of no better person to bring some cheer to the Military College of South Carolina, now called for Jessica.
Tate Matthew Alexander.
Athleticism and a genuine care of others, and a chemical mashup guaranteed to yield a positive reaction. We have enjoyed his quiet humor, and we have valued his solid contributions to our community. His rowdier peers have calmed in his presence, which has made Tate priceless to the teaching staff. We are sorry to let students like Tate Alexander out of our clutches, but we know godly impossibles like him will not stay long hidden under a bushel.
Gabriella Marie Babasa.
Gabriella has never met a stranger. She uses her own natural charms to put people at ease. She's like Velcro when it comes to the broken or the unseen. And she will stick to them until they feel noticed, accepted, and loved. She also has a gifted and most singular singing voice. And when she opens her mouth, the stars shine brighter and the angels take note.
Zachary Aaron Babasa.
Says, nice guys finish last, obviously haven't met Zach. Zach is CCA's president of his club. However, you might not know that. I think Zach was overcome with the word whiz kid, but we know him to be a whiz kid. Thank you. However, you might not know about his academic achievements because he is so humble. The only thing that can outpace his brilliance is his cool demeanor and affable attitude. Never one to add to the white noise of the classroom, Zach's contributions are sharp and well-reasoned. His restraint and sense of humor puts those around him at ease, and his warm presence will be missed in the CCA classrooms and hallways next year. Now, let's hear it for Zach.
Julia Elizabeth Barr.
Julia is the quintessential leader. We know this from her work in sports, robotics, student government, and as stage manager for the school's play. She's a deep thinker who researches a topic before forming an opinion and knows how to wrestle through the gauntlet of other opinions, hold on to logic, and come to a common sense conclusion. She's an extremely hard worker, as well as a delightful person. We wish her all the best as she heads out to study at Texas Tech.
Abigail Ruth Cagle.
Abigail is Chapelgate's resident philologist. Don't know what that means? We didn't either until we met Abigail. Someone with that title treasures words and no words more revered by Abigail Cagle than God's holy word. We know that because we see Abigail live out the gospel every day with her kindness, her joy, her intelligence, and her creativity. We are grateful that we have had Abigail with us at Chapelgate for the last 7 years, and we can't wait to see how she authors the rest of her story.
Hillary Christina Herrera.
Hillary is a woman of diverse gifts and talents. She came to us this year and quickly joined and participated in several activities at CCA. She played on the soccer and softball teams and was Queen of Transylvania in this year's production of My Fair Lady. Hillary's commitment to friends and family have been often expressed by her concerns for others and her prompt regard for their needs. Her natural intelligence, kindness, and joy-filled smile been quite a blessing to the family of Chapelgate Christian Academy.
Mario Jaden Cherry.
Let's focus on Mario now. Chapelgate is truly going to miss this bright smile, quick feet of Jaden Cherry. Since enrolling in CCA his freshman year, Jaden has been an integral part of the Yellow Jackets soccer team. He also played club soccer for HCC. Jaden is a loyal friend and excellent big brother. He's now kicking his soccer ball towards Towson University, where he will enter as a pre-med major.
Danielle Ellis Clark.
During her time with us at Chapelgate, Danielle has blessed this community with her many, many talents. From her expertise as a visual artist, her lovely voice, and her skills as a problem solver in her many math and science classes, Danielle makes use of both sides of her brain, no matter which way you cut it. As she continues to march forward to her own beat, we will remain ever so grateful that she added her particular melodic strains to our listening ears.
John Alexander Ernest Cofield.
John has worked on many things during his years at Chapelgate. He's gone from being a rapper to the ever-lovable Buzz to a skilled basketball player in his own right. One thing that John refuses to change is his kindness towards his fellow students and the respect he shows his teachers. He will successfully navigate the shifting seasons of life ahead of him because he will adapt to new circumstances while loving and honoring the image of God in those around him.
Julian Copeland.
Julian played 1 year of JV and 2 years of varsity basketball. He was part of the Broad 40 Christian School Tournament Championship team and the Catonsville Cup Tournament winners. He was also named as a participant in the Buffalo Wild Wings All-Star Game in March. All this in addition to the fact that Julian is a serious student who helped establish math and science study sessions during the past 3 years. Julian is taking his big-time smile and personality off to college next year, where he will be the best version of himself. He certainly displayed that here at CCA.
Hannah A. Daniel.
Our noiseless Hannah is a woman of integrity, strength, and conviction. She leads by example, asserting her views and opinions when necessary. When Hannah speaks, people listen. She has a depth of insight and maturity that belie her years. She's a quiet yet remarkable young woman. No door will hear the sound of her footsteps, but nevertheless, doors will fly open to welcome a person as inimitable as Hannah.
Titus Nathaniel Dingle.
This young man is a tall drink of water, quenching all of us with cool drafts of gentleness, kindness, friendship, and desire to do an excellent job wherever he lands. And we love it when he can land without bumping his head. Titus landed on our stage, West Side Story, the COVID and non-COVID renditions, and in My Fair Lady. He was purpose, focused, talented, and just simply wonderful to have around. He's a tried and true friend. Drink up, everyone.
Jamin Jax Felder.
Jax is a young man of impeccable character. He is kind, thoughtful, hardworking, and diligent. He's a fierce fighter, which we saw on the basketball court and elsewhere with friends and family. He looks to the Lord first in all things and cares for others before himself. Jax is committed to playing basketball next year at Lancaster Bible College. Ladies and gentlemen, look closely, because this is what an honest, goodness, true champion looks like.
Isabel Estelle Florent.
Has ever created, but she is not afraid to use it to speak up. She's a smart and autonomously thinking young woman. As a fearless volleyball player, she led her team to first place in the conference. Diligent in her studies, she actually excels in anything she tackles, and that includes making friends. And once you are a friend of Isabel's, you are a friend for life. This courageous young woman will be greatly used by our God. This world needs more women like Isabel Florent.
Benjamin Scott Heaps.
This student puts the shine on the diamond, as in baseball diamonds. Sorry, girls. Ben has done nothing but dazzle during his career here at Chapelgate, and his talents extend far beyond the baseball field, as he also played varsity soccer and is a lead instrumentalist in the symphonic band. Ben is a hard worker, whether in the classroom, on the field, or as an assistant in the media center. He gives it his all. He is leading our five now, but will totally slay next year at Waynesburg University.
Selah Grace Holland.
It's apropos that the word Selah is a musical direction. In the Bible, since our own Selah directs us musically as well. And though she has a marvelous singing voice, it's not the only lyricism she conducts us with. She has escorted us through the very songs themselves, showing us her close walk with God and her comportment in difficult times. We wish all could sing the endless, beautiful song of Selah.
Jonathan Luke Idoni.
Jonathan has that rare combination of intelligence and humility. He works with excellence and integrity, oblivious as to how remarkable he is. He is committed to Christ and analyzes life and current events through a biblical lens. Working with these strengths will surely cause the world to notice. He can smile at his future as he continues to be a first-class citizen of this world and the world to come. Adani from the President, 2048.
Jair Daniel Jackson.
Jair came into Chapelgate in sixth grade year and has been swimming laps around these halls ever since. Quick-witted and determined to achieve excellence both in and out of the classroom, Jair offered both deep insights and humorous commentary. Most aptly happens. Jair is at the swimming pool, swimming his way to the IFSCA Senior Cup Final and Sectional Championship Meet. Jair will take his academic and swimming prowess to St. Mary's College next year.
Abram Denzel Johnson.
There is a giggle inside this young man that giggles out every now and then that will be well remembered as an echo in the halls for years to come. Abram enjoys writing creatively, and has been voted by his classmates as best gamer. He is friendly, and his joyful, playful heart has left a spirit of delight in all his classes. And that's been Abram's best game strategy all along.
Benjamin Eric Johnson.
Ben is an incredibly hard worker. He's one of the first students in the building every day because this early bird is eager to make beautiful music on his trumpet as soon as the sun meets the sky. He has twice played in our big orchestra, contributing his talent to our performance efforts. Ben is funny and the epitome of a well-rounded student. Now it's our turn to take his instrument toys from his hands and trumpet his past exploits at CCA and his future creative endeavors to the world.
Anaya Sierra Jones.
Elegance and quiet fortitude for the past 6 years. But lo and behold, when she steps onto the volleyball court, her fierce competitive spirit wipes all that away. Anaya will be heading out to North Carolina A&T in fall, where she will focus on liberal studies and pre-law. She's definitely someone you want beside you before a judge's bench.
Junmo Ibra Kang.
Ibra is quietly brilliant, an outstanding engineer. He almost single-handedly kept Team Vector running on all four wheels. He is good for an in-depth discussion of math or physics anytime. But don't think for a moment that an in-depth discussion of math and physics would be a lame conversation. Nothing is further from the truth when it comes to evil. He is a positively fascinating conversationalist because of his encyclopedic understanding of things. And he will be missed next year.
Karen Lillian Lawson.
Karen is a gifted visual artist. She can paint, draw, and sculpt with unusual ideas and strange materials and with great skill. She's a very soft-spoken, quiet person, but she's a loud and explosive artist. Her talented work announces itself via a humongous megaphone, and the world will soon know about it. She will be studying architecture and is fluent in French. We have visions of a new Eiffel Tower being erected by our own Karen Paulson.
Gray Nyla Lewis.
This is one of our couples involved in honors and AP courses and nailed them all. She has also worked as a preschool assistant and was an integral part of the yearbook staff. There's nothing gray or neutral in this Gray's life. She's full of color and she's been a rainbow of dedicated effort and hard work.
Eden Sarah Magnus.
Eden is smart, funny, and hardworking. She is creative, empathetic, is able to read people well, and faces life with self-deprecating humor. In addition to her studies here, she has worked in a nursing home for the past 2 years, caring for patients, even during the height of COVID, often covering for co-workers and taking on extra shifts. She's leaving us now to pursue a nursing degree at Towson University, hoping to serve others as a traveling nurse.
Michael John Mahoney.
Grit and determination describe Michael. This is especially evident on the lacrosse field when running the cross-country course. Playing through injury and pain in order to give his team the best chance to win speaks of Michael's character. This kind of tenacious fortitude is seen not only on the athletic fields, but in the classroom as well, particularly as he painted his way through creative roadblocks and perceived phantom pain in the art park. Michael now leaves to continue his education at James Madison University.
Kyla Hale, Leona Miles.
We know about this young lady was talented pretty much on the day she stepped into our school. That was the day our spotlights turned on by their own accord. She has a massive singing voice, a fearless presence on stage, and even with a bum knee, she could have waltzed with Fred Astaire. It's not easy to make it Broadway, but Kyla L. will get there because our God gave her a great big gift, and there's no possible way to hide a present of that magnitude from the world.
Oraluwa Emmanuel Olajide.
Emmanuel walked on his Chapelgate journey just a few short years ago at the height of the COVID pandemic. He managed to assimilate to a new school and a new system of hybrid learning all in 1 year. He played in the pit orchestra this year for My Fair Lady, and he served as senior class president. But mostly, he served as a friend to all, and that's a position he has mastered and benefited from. You'll find it all in his name, Emmanuel. God is with us.
Yeah.
physically right before our very eyes.
He added a good 4 inches to his height alone. He loved his basketball and his family, but not necessarily a lot of work. He helped his team during his junior and senior years with some serious defensive skills and vocal cords that could bellow, keep your heads up, and it's not all that bad, we can do it. This year, he joined the lacrosse team and riled things up on the field. Austin will now lead the Hordes of Zombies and will be majoring in communications at HCC and hopes to play basketball there.
Braden Xavier Smith.
The audience, again, thank you. We really want to read this. We want to rejoice with everyone, but we want to wait and then we can cheer it on, right? You know, we want this at this moment to be about Braden, and Braden is awesome. He has an unexpected wit that brought a lot of fun and laughter into the classroom. He worked hard and helped fellow classmates as they struggled to understand difficult courses, concepts, a la unit circle. As both an entrepreneur and an accomplished baseball player, he carries a team player mindset and practical life skills to college with him. In the future, when life hits a bump, Braden will be there to work through it with a wisecrack or two.
Eric Joseph Spees.
I think if there was an Academy Award for Best Perfect Student, Eric Spees would win hands down. He is a gentleman in every aspect of the word who lives to serve others. Ask Eric to do anything, his answer is always in the affirmative. Not only will you get compliance, but you get the task done with a cheerful heart. He's made himself available night and day, and it's hard not to take advantage of such a person. So without hesitation, this Academy is pleased to present the Oscar for Best Perfect Student to Eric Spees.
Daniel Richard Sundy.
Daniel has a style and panache of a cool hand, loose kind of guy. He is a friend who can be counted on. He is one of Chapelgate's star lacrosse players. He and Mario, his brother from another mother, will one day take the business world by storm with their Elon Musk kind of deals. Danielle was this year's CCA resident video design intern. He created the logo and branding for this year's musical performance of My Fair Lady and then edited the final video. There's a whole lot that can be accomplished in the hands, in the cool hands of Daniel Sunday.
Miriam Alaluayeni Tukulia.
This girl is a great life. Her joyful smile and exuberant personality have the unique capacity to outshine the sun. She is an accomplished student who focuses on excellence by setting high goals for herself. She pursues righteousness, and her love for the Lord is evident in the compassion she shows others. She is a performing artist who has devoted her time and talent to CCA shows and reviews. Her energy and joy will be missed, and we wish her great success as she dances into her next adventure.
Thomas Michael Burgess.
While Tommy loves to draw people in with a roused debate, one he must always win, he loves nothing more than to make people laugh. He jokes, designs pranks, and does whatever nonsense necessary to bring a bit of cheer into the room. As a serious writer, Tommy is perceptive and uses that gift to forge relationships and foster a sense of community. Even when forced to be online, his big heart hosted bonfires so friends and families could get together. His wit and kindness will be missed as he heads off to Ohio for college.
Yeah. Nicholas Aiden Wilkins.
Nick is a man for kindness and strong integrity. We have loved seeing him use those attributes when dealing with difficult situations that occasionally arise. He tried his hand at the visual arts this year, and no one was more surprised than Nick himself that project after project turned out successfully. He is also a talented videographer who is patient, teachable, and well-liked by everyone. This godly young man makes being nice look effortless, and we have fallen under his graciousness from seeing his heart vehemently warm upon his sleeve.
Keon Andre Wright.
As a yellow jacket, Keon has lived up to our mascot, demonstrating well above average doses, perseverance, courage, and spirit. Jumping into the COVID year, feet first and ready to run, was enough to convince us of his maturity, but he was only getting started. Throughout his Chapelgate tenure, Keon has been a role model to all students young and older. This young athlete has literally seized the day and is now off to play basketball on the court of St. Mary's College.
So, none of this can happen without parents. And it goes way further than paying tuition, although that seems to be what my parents focus on. From waking us up in the morning, to cooking us breakfast, to driving us to school, you provide the ingredients for academic success. But now, all my classmates are looking at me saying, I wake myself up, like I drive myself to school. But thanks to our parents, we have smartphones and we can set alarms on for school. We have pantries full of food so we can make our own breakfasts. We have car insurance so that we can drive to school 9 inches. When we didn't know what class to take, you gave us advice. When we did really well on an assignment, you gave us encouragement. And when we did really not so well, you gave us comfort. We literally could not be here without you all. Proverbs 22:6 says, train up a child in the way he should go, and when he is old, he will not depart from it. I want to sincerely thank all of our parents for raising us in godly homes and teaching us about our true parent, our Father in heaven. Now, I know you're wondering, what are these roses for? So, we have a gift for all of our parents. So, before we turn on tassels, I can say this. Seniors, please find your parents.
Thank you. Evening, ladies and gentlemen. I have the amazing privilege to be closing this out here tonight. For those who are not aware, my name is Mary Watson. After the events of the school year, we came to a total of $4,440.54. We decided to use the money in two ways. We have a donation for $2,000 to our middle school. And the second one goes to an academic scholarship for SGA. So now, as classroom person, I invite Vice President Sayla Hall, Secretary Julie Barr, and Treasurer Jonathan Adon, and the rest of our senior class to turn their tassels from the right to the left.
Christ and all they say, and praise him in his name. Amen.
Amen.